We've got an amazing tree here. Anyone guess what it is?
The butterfly flying down the tree.
What kind of tree is it?
Baobab tree.
A baobab tree. And this is the flower. I wanted to share that with you because it's just so exceptional. Where's the fruit?
There.
Oh.
There's
a baobab
tree.
Is it? Can you eat it, Elia?
No.
Oh, are you sure? You had drinks made of that. The old flower.
These ones are baby ones,
aren't they? Oh, there's butterflies here. Everywhere.
It's too small.
That's the beauty of it.
Because Daddy, this one's getting so big.
Tony, what can you do with a baobab if you don't mind me asking?
Well, the fruits have a white pulp on them that's dried and used to make a drink. That's really nice, it's sort of a sweet. Sweet juice, and then the leaves are dried into a powder that's added to soups and things. It's apparently high vitamin. Do you want to climb the tree, sweetheart?
Yeah.
Do you want to climb the baobab?
Yes.
But it's also like the baobab trees here in Gambia. They say that they're a sign of where people live, and so when you drive out in the countryside, you'll see these big clusters of masses of baobab trees, and that's an old settlement because wherever people have lived, they've put the baobabs. So, which is quite interesting. Yeah.
And we've eaten some pulp of it, didn't we?
Yeah. Yeah.
But I can cut baobab down.
Okay, another look at the flower here. So this plant is getting pollinated by insects. It's obvious that it's waiting for something, isn't it? So it's reasonable to believe that the plant is cross-pollinating. And here we are in the Gambia, the country of butterflies. Look at that, they are everywhere. And every plant here is edible or medicinal. It's beautiful. People live out of that.
Show Michelle how big that is.